And doctor, during a spinal fracture, where does it occur and what happens?
Well, that's a very good question. A spinal fracture can really occur at any of the sections that we previously discussed,
okay,
at any of the points at that particular vertebral body level. And so, if you can see here on the mouse here, what we're going to be mostly talking about today are vertebral body fractures, all right? And the mouse here is pointing to the vertebral body. That's the bulky part of the spine that takes all of the forces of our daily life.
Mm-hmm.
Back here, let me see if I can move this for us.
I think you do it this way.
There we go.
Is that correct?
These are called the posterior elements, the parts that you can kind of feel through your skin. These are the spinous processes back here. And then these little things sticking out are the transverse processes. In the thoracic spine, those are connected to the ribs. And so you can have spinal fractures that range from very minor, that would be a fracture of these transverse processes here.
Mm-hmm.
Those don't even require any treatment except for maybe some pain medications. But the spinal fractures can range up to some very serious fractures where the spine actually separates in half. Those are usually involved with traumatic injuries, car accidents, motorcycle accidents, or severe falls. And so it runs the whole gamut of extremity, and so we deal with all of those.